All right. Hello. Welcome. Happy New Year. New year. New me. New you. New us. New everything. 2024. There was a Reddit thread in the Obsidian subreddit that was just like, hey, what's your favorite theme? And so obviously I had to go, well, it's MagicUser. I've been using it since, basically since it friggin' came out in September. October, November, 4 months now? 4 months? And usually I like to switch around themes quite often. I kind of get bored and I just hop around and I go and see, oh, what looks cool now? But I haven't done it with MagicUser. I've just been using it and I just like it a lot. It's very, I don't know, it's delightful, I think. So I'm going to show you a new vault that's got just the default. It's like the sandbox vault that they give you with MagicUser installed. And I'll just go through the default settings. I'll switch the sub themes a little bit, give you an idea. And then I'll go through the thread on the Obsidian forums. Some of the more recent posts, they've been updating it quite a lot. There's always new little things being added. Tables look very nice. Code themes, look at all this. So I'm going to talk about this stuff in a little bit because it's very cool. But now let's go. This is the default setup for MagicUser. You know, very simple, pleasant to look at blue theme. You know, we got some block formatting. We got callouts. Some of the really interesting stuff is just the little touches it does like this, right? It glows. Any element that you click and hold on will glow to kind of give you a really clear idea of what you're selecting right there. Lists, and of course you've got this really nice indicator, block level indicator to the left of whatever you're hovering over. Ooh, see, it's just so nice. It's just very, very interesting. There's like just a bunch of little stuff here. Now, if you install the theme from the, from the community themes, and then you install the style settings plugin, you're gonna get a lot of stuff here. So, there's a lot of sub themes. So this is just the basic. Default one, MagicUser. Let's go to Room Lamp. MagicUser. Let's go to the next one, Purple. See? Look at that. And we also got Teal. Nice, nice. Camouflage. A little similar to Room Lamp, maybe. And this is the one that I usually use, the gray. And I use the gray in the dark theme. So this is sort of how my vault generally looks, my actual vault. And I'll show you some of that too as well. So this is the gray in the dark theme. I didn't show you the dark versions of the other ones. So this is the dark version of the default. Then we got Room Lamp, which is very different, right? This is like a wine. This is a wine one right here. Purple. Teal. This is actually a very pleasant green. I like this. Camouflage. All right, now let's go to Moon. Night. Ooh. Ooh, I like that. Night synth. Ooh. We're in the gradient zone here. Dreams. Purple dreams. Slide. Oh, look at that. I like the bright yellow. Oh, I like these. my accent color. If you go into appearance, you can set an accent color that persists throughout theme changes that different themes will use in different little ways, you know. Most commonly, it seems to be like menu selections and stuff like that. Maybe it'll be like the hover color over links or different things. I usually use a pink. Pink's one of my favorite colors. And so I use the dark gray theme with a pink accent, and I really like it. The BG Classic. All right. UI settings. Main theme colors, icons, and folders. So you can turn on or off whether or not there's icons for the folders and files there, which is useful. You couldn't do that initially. That's a kind of more recent inclusion. And I used to use a plugin that would let you do emojis and custom icons for different folders and stuff. And it would just have the custom icon and then the MagicUser icon next to it. Now you can turn those off if you need to. You can change the icon focus color, the file icon's color, the folder icon's color, folder name color. There is a lot of customization, indent guides, different colors for indent guides. Let's jump over to this for a bit. So in the thread, there's some good examples of the more custom stuff that MagicUser does, not just like the standard markdown stuff that you see in the sandbox vault. Mainly, we got a lot of really cool callout stuff. So as you can see here, you can do, there's a lot of custom callouts, a lot. And most of them will let you change the color. There's, it looks like, 6-7 colors that you can choose from. And then there's a couple special cases as well. So to do a callout with a, you know, a heading with a green background, for example, you do the regular callout like you normally would, and then you do the exclamation H, and then a number 1 through 6, and then a color. So H2-green will give you this one right here, H1-green, the larger H1. And you can see you can do blue, orange, yellow, etc. There's also media callouts, which I enjoy using. Basically, they'll kind of give you a really nice sort of frame for an image that you're putting on there in your note, and then put the text below it. It's very, very good. You've only got 3 options, but it's all you need, really. I use them for the MediaDB plugin, and then I put, you know, the like movie poster or whatever that the plugin pulls from IMDb or Steam or whatever into these, and it works out very nice, very pleasant. Of course, you've got all the same colors for the different quotes. And you've got some custom ones here that'll give you cool little icons. So a paperclip, magic, which will give you a little wand, microphone, and a little video one. So these are in addition to the icons that you can normally use. The little like pencil and the warning icon and the little bug icon and all those, you know, however many. This gives you just a few more to work with. These are the custom checkboxes. And then if we go down here, so the ones from the last few days. So 2 weeks ago, rainbow colored background folders. So you can see here, just some more customization options to really group your the File Explorer tree window pane. Rainbow colored background folders. Oh, yes. And so now it'll also, when you expand a folder, it will kind of put all of these subfolders and subfiles that are within that folder into a little fenced off colored area, which is very cool. I like it a lot. I think one of the things that Obsidian is really underdeveloped in is the File Explorer. It's just super basic. You can do a little bit customization default, but it's very basic. And something like this, I think, really helps it stand out and gives it just a little bit more usability that you don't have otherwise. I also highly recommend the Obsidian Custom Sort plugin that I did a video about November, December. They can also give you some really powerful tools to utilize the Explorer, File Explorer panel. Okay, so this was 1 week ago, and we've got the cool glowing headings. Neon mode. So let's go and let's turn that on right now. Neon mode. Click. And then let's go. Oh, look at that. Formatting. Heading. I understand it's a little decadent. It's a little flashy. But I don't feel like this distracts me. I feel like it just like keeps me entertained, keeps me a little focused, keeps me on track. There's definitely some themes I've used that take this kind of thing to the extreme that personally kind of, it's too much for me personally. But I feel like the stuff that MagicUser does is just enough to like keep my interest on Obsidian and makes it so I don't really want to wander away, which is difficult for me. And reading glow effect to highlight important areas, which I already showed you. That's this glowing. Oh yeah, this was interesting. This was 5 days ago. I haven't used this yet, but there's some custom classes that were added that interact with data view specifically to make it so that you get these little. Instead of just a list like this, you will get a pop in like a card setting, which I know some other themes have done similar stuff. See, inspired by, yeah. And I used minimal for a while and I liked it a lot. All right, 3 days ago. Oh, this is the highlight. So this is where you can change the color of the highlighting. And then just 2 days ago, I think that's the most recent one. So that's when the new ones were added, the ones with the gradient backgrounds. And yeah, it looks like the light mode version is just the same. These are just exclusively dark mode ones. Heavily influenced by the 80s style and music. I don't feel like anything is really there superfluously. You know, I like it so much. I find it really fun. All right, so this is my current vault. I'm not going to go too much into it now. I plan to do a little, like, brief walkthrough. But you can see I've got one of the green callouts here at the top. If I go to one of the MediaDB pages, you'll see that I've got the I've got a colored block quote up here. I've got one of the media callouts here with the poster of the movie, and then some typical sort of stuff from MediaDB. Dreadful trilogy. Do not watch it. Disgustingly bad. Anyway, but MagicUser is disgustingly good. And you can see down here, I've got the calendar, a little widget with the pink there. That's my accent color. So yeah, that is MagicUser. I apologize for my camera. I don't know what's going on. I've got an entirely new setup. This is Obsidian running on the Steam Deck. If you get your hands on a Steam Deck, you can put Obsidian on it. It's quite easy. That is MagicUser. It's my favorite theme right now. It has been since September when it came out. All right. Thank you. Have fun. Or don't. You're your own person. You can do what you want. Don't have fun. Do have fun. See ya.